He says, but it wasn't, it was just after Beetle Week last year, when Paul McCartney made a statement that the council were looking for somebody to take on the Bonthouse Church and try and do something with it, find a new owner or a plan to do something with it. And basically Paul just appealed for the people of Liverpool to get behind whatever happens so that it doesn't go to waste. Obviously Paul went to school just up the road here at Liverpool Institute, so he would have been walking past this, as it still looks today, it was exactly the same when Paul was at school. So he remembers it fondly as a child. So he wanted people to get behind it and support whatever happens here. So that's when Bill thought, well, you know, if anyone's going to get behind it, it's got to be the Beatles fans, hasn't it? So it was thanks to Paul McCartney as to why we're here today. But also a people week, it's thanks to Paul McCartney that we're here today. And John and George and Ringo as well. And it gives me great pleasure to introduce this next, I don't know if it's an artist or musician or lunatic, to be honest with you.
Heritage Act.
Beetle Week 2015 Heritage Act. You're not as old as you look. Ladies and gents, the legend that is Mr. Neil Innes.
Thank you. And how about Hal? Wasn't he wonderful? Made the guitar talk. Okay, my name is Neil Innes, as he just told you. I won't be doing any Beatles songs, so I hope I don't disappoint you. But I am one of the few people on the planet to have been impersonated by Elvis Presley. More of that later. Here's a song about television called Eye Candy. I was sitting in my armchair watching my TV, searching for something half decent to see. I settled on a blockbuster action movie, and in no time at all, the hero was me. I was using strong language, chasing bad guys, all hell breaking loose before my eyes. Explosions, car chases, and fake alibis, but naked babes with tattooed thighs. Only to find myself in match of the day, scoring a last minute goal against the runoff play. But no sooner had the referee's whistle been blown, I was sucked into a computer graphics cyclone. I'm dumped on a sofa with a cartoon telephone, telling me how easy it can be to get alone. Frequenters, wacky co-presenters, ay, 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 eye candy, effluent up and you put it on, mas media. Actually, there's a lot of words in this song, isn't there? It's a lot to take in one go. Maybe I should take a leaf out of television's book and throw in a commercial. Yes, it's come to this. Oh yeah. Feeling peckish, always on the run, you need cock-a-doodle-tater. Cock-a-doodle-tater, a really good potato with the chicken inside. I was being zapped around from place to place, from World War II in color to Alice.
outer space, trying to save the future of the human race. I was the one with the lumps on his face. I was a TV chef, jumping up a courgette. I was an emergency animal hospital vet. With my hand up some fluffy family pet, I was trapped inside my own TV set. In a mixture of panic and darkest despair, I tapped on the glass to see if someone was there. I saw myself sitting in my old easy chair. I waited, but all I got was an empty stare. I knew I was in trouble, my head was in a spin, my reality dissolving like a aspirin. I was in the room full of goodness and multivitamins. I was the toilet bowl germ with a wicked grin. Ay, 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 ay. We are coming.
about this place, you know, this is a song I did years and years ago with a Ragtime album. But it's, if I can't do this song here, where can I do this song? So I'm going to do it. I've never done it in public before.
Fun just after the First World War.
Another kind of song we liked was the songs with band shouts. The singer would sing something and then the band would all shout together. Something like this. He kissed her.
Who did?
He did.
Where?
On her doorstep last night.
He hugged her.
Who did?
He did.
Where?
On her doorstep last night.
He said, you are my darling Kate, and squeezed his fingers in the garden gate and then kissed her.
Who did?
He did. Just move on without giving you the opportunity of experiencing the fun of doing a band shout. So I sing, he kissed her, you go, who did? I go, he did, and you go, where? And then you get some idea of the terrific fun to be had when doing the band shout. This isn't just any ordinary fun, this is fun that will last a lifetime. Fun that just keeps on giving. Fun that goes to heaven. So,
he kissed her.
He did.
He did.
Where?
Her doorstep last night.
He hugged her.
He did.
Where?
Her doorstep last night.
He said, you are my darling Kate. Then he squeezed his fingers in the garden gate and then he kissed her.
He
did.
Where?
Her doorstep last night. Fantastic. Became more popular by playing in pubs, and eventually we got a record contract. And we went off to make our first recording in Boston, Abbey Road. But the song we chose to do was a thing called My Brother Makes the Noises for the Talkies, and it went like this. My brother makes the noises for the talkies. There's not a single noise that he can't do. If you've forgotten what a popping cork is, a pretty cork for you. He'll do the steam escaping from liners leaving duck. He'll fake a razor scraping on a chuckle. My brother makes the noises for the talkies. He's not a single noise, but he can do. This is what I hear when I'm in bed. A bang, a crash, like thunder overhead. Cats meow, a dog's bow wow. The only sleep I get is when I'm dead. The only time he made a bundle was when a tiger in the jungle with a mighty roar dropped dead with bullets in his head and rattled like a cow instead. Moo, my brother makes the noises. Will you get the idea? There's a lot of sound effects, and there weren't any CDs in those days. We had to do it ourselves. Anyway, the lads were all busy doing sound effects when I felt full of nature. And in Abbey Road, you used to come out of the studios, go down the main corridor, down some steps, and there the restrooms are. So coming back, I was coming up the steps, and there, in the front door, silhouetted from the sunshine outside, were four guys with very distinctive haircuts and pointy shoes and tight trousers. And, you know, two big riders. And I thought, it's them. Of course, they record here too, don't they? But my curiosity got the better of me. I snuck out and I listened outside the studio to what they were doing. And it was something on one of George's, and like this. Listening to this panel coming from even through the doorway, this F over the E. Anyway, I went back in our street and finished off. My brother makes the noises for the talkies.
What's about there?
Hello. So, yeah, that's. I don't know about you, but I'm having the time of my life.
We all are.
What choice have we got? But time is one of those things that always intrigues me. You know, because when you think about it, time is just man-made. Nature isn't time. Time is man-made. You know, if it's up to nature, everything would just all happen at once. So, if you can imagine, here we are on the exact spot where the past and the future meet. All the time. Right. It's like infinity all the time. I don't know about you, but you know, I love things like infinity. I just can't get enough of it. Okay. Here's a song about time called Stealing Time.
Talk so queer.
tea.
Dinosaur.